white and yellow blonde fur there is around the snout area. And also, this is the place where they found the two otters, like, actually holding hands, that really viral video. But the other thing that people don't know is that otters are really, really voracious. One of the differences between sea lions and seals is that for sea lions, you can look at their heads and their ears. So sea lions have little ear flaps, whereas seals don't. Also, sea lions tend to look a lot more, like, elegant, like angels swimming in the water, but seals kind of are just, like, big and round and kind of fat. Also, seals on land, when they move around, they kind of, like, go like this, and it's called galumping.
There's a harbor seal. There's that giant big boy, and then the sleeping other boy, and then there's one in the back. Another boy.
This is Helen, the Pacific white-sided dolphin here at the Vancouver Aquarium, the last station here. You can tell the difference between her and a previous Pacific white-sided dolphin, Hannah, because of her short nubs in her pectoral fins. That's where she got caught in a Japanese fishing net, and that was when she was redeemed that she can go back into the wild and here housed at the Vancouver Aquarium. Okay, so these are African penguins. There's three boys and three girls, and you can tell the difference because they have an armband, and on their armband they have like a little bead, and then that is their name, and they were all named after cities in BC. So there is one called Hope. I like Hope.
We gotta keep one sturgeon awake.
These are the moon jellies, and they have stomachs of the top, which are the circles. You can tell them when they're fed if they are orange, and then sometimes you can find mutations where there's like 5 or 6 or 7 jellies. They don't have brains, and these moon jellies are really harmless. You can find them like everywhere in Vancouver in the harbors.
This is the Black Indian triggerfish. Just love my life. When there is a little like trigger on top of its fin, he swims really fast. He's been here forever. He's like the best. He's gotten, I think, more yellow, and he likes to swim around. I think he's gotten bigger. He's so cute, by the way.
Rockfish can live up to 100 years old, even older sometimes.
Oh, handsome.
Yeah. Here, those are some perches. Those are some sea anemones that you can find. I think that's a rose anemone.
Those are tube worms with a little, they're black with the feathers, so if you touched it, it would go inside the tube.
This is what you would usually see in the docks of BC. These are my favorite rockfish.
You can see over here, up above, you can see it's feeding the leather stars. If you touch them, they smell like garlic.
Also, like, sea stars are just monsters with mouths.
Like, if there was ever a B movie up there of like a giant monster, it'd probably be a sea star. They move slowly, but they just eat everything.
There's a sturgeon in the back, and they're the biggest freshwater fish in the world. They're so cute. That was kind of a baby. And then there's like these flatfish that are not so flat. And then there's a skate, which is really, really flat.
Poop snouts! Spot prawns!
And these are the freshwater corals of BC. And then over there, there's a cookie star.
That hermit crab. Great, yeah, that one. It has a sea anemone growing on its shell. Keep going. Keep going.
The pufferfish from the north that I like to call, even though they're more related to rockfish and pufferfish, but they're so cute when they swim.
What's it called?
Pacific spiny lumpsucker. Sea cucumbers. This is a great exhibit.
There's the clownfish. Where's my son? Triggerfish from the meme. Porcupine fish, Diodon holocanthus, the love of my life.
There's dwarf poppers here. I didn't know this. These little tiny teeny assholes, and they're great. These dwarf poppers. Look at them. Look at the
cichlids in here, and then there's also a pleco catfish over there. They're awesome. And then over here we have some rays. There is a fuzzy sloth in the tree. There are some scarlet ibises and ducks here. There used to be two hyacinth macaws, blue macaws, that were here, Gus and Ollie, and they were bonded for life. Thank you.
more cute, and they're more related to these little tetra fish, so they're relatives. And then for special effects, there are bones. Thanks for watching. Wait, my mask is different. Thanks for watching the video. That was the Vancouver Aquarium tour. Heard of a normal sponge, your everyday regular sponge, but there's also tennis ball sponges.